Now I have the opportunity to greet you from the Maidan.
I hope this video complements my previous material. I want a home workshop for metalwork. I have several used machine tools, a lathe, a milling machine, and a surface grinder. All the machines will need to be reconditioned before a high standard of machining can be produced. How accurately can metal processing be performed in an ordinary hobby workshop? I prepared to repair my machines and started looking for the appropriate tools to test the existing machines and to test the improvements I made. It turned out that these are very expensive instruments if their quality is certified. I was not willing to pay such a high price, so bought several used standards, including a surface plate and a used straight edge. The surface plate is the standard that almost everything is judged by. It should be as flat as possible and to a national or international standard. It was not known what state the geometry of my used planes were in, but I hoped that I would be able to return them to the accuracy provided for by the standards. Fortunately, I was able to complete this task, and even much better than I expected. Not only have I brought them to a condition that meets the established standards of accuracy for this tool, I managed to exceed the highest requirements of strict standards. I did not have expensive high-precision equipment or special temperature control of the room. In my videos, I show you how it was done. The channel has separate, more detailed videos about each standard I have improved. Of course, you need to accurately identify high spots and remove them until the surface is to the standard you require. It is possible to use grinding for fast removal of metal and scraping or lapping for final finishing. For lapping, you just need an appropriate flat lapping base and fine abrasive to give accurate flatness. If the lapping is done properly, the lapping base should also become flatter, as it is used as the lapping tends to average the two surfaces. There is a separate video on the channel showing how I did it and what accuracy has been achieved. I have already published a number of videos on this topic. I prepared the surface of the plate for the experiment. It's an interesting method. The straight edge is positioned on clean surface plate on 2 feet, each is a 1.995 millimeters gauge block positioned at the points of least deflection. For the test showing in this video, two more gauge blocks are needed, 1994 microns, the second 1995 microns. The difference between them is 1 micron. The difference in their size is very small. To understand how small a difference it is, I used a figurative analogy. There are 1,995 sheets in this stack of paper. Conventionally, this is the height of the larger gauge block. And now, this is the height of the smaller gauge block. Special thanks to the viewers for supporting me on Patreon. The straight edge was lapped freehand, not using anything to keep the base of the straight edge perfectly horizontal to the lapping plate. As a result, the edges are slightly rounded. Therefore, the test block plunges into the gap a little before it gets stuck. I try to press the slab, the gauge block and the straight edge as tightly as possible to each other, compress them and wiggle the gauge block, because sometimes dust gets in. A gap of 1.995 mm is formed between the plate and the straight edge. First, I apply a 1.995 gauge block, the same size as the support blocks. The straight edge is tested by trying to gently push a gauge block underneath. I have made a cardboard pusher. The cardboard spring gives gentle and relatively consistent pressure. It is easy to judge the position of the test gauge block as the cardboard spring lifts up as pressure is applied. If we assume that the area of the straight edge and the surface plate is less than a micron, then the gap will be the same everywhere within 1 micron. Now I am pushing through a gauge block that's only 1 micron thinner. It will only pass through a perfectly accurate gap. And that's exactly what happens. Needs to be demagnetized. Those who are interested in this topic are usually very meticulous people and prefer to check everything, to check in as much detail as possible. Therefore, I turn over the straight edge and repeat the experiment. As you can see, the result is repeated. The gap in each place is the same size. Wherever I place the straight edge on the surface of the plate, the result is repeated. the gap is always less than 1995 microns and greater than 1994 microns. Sometimes accidents happen. There was a metallic knock, which means there is a dent. Fortunately, part the size of the straight edge is protected by the cardboard I glue to the sides to prevent the heat from my hands, affecting the geometry of the items being tested. Having a dent, a small area that is lower than the rest of the surface, is not a problem, but it will have a raised bar that needs to be removed, as that would change the geometry completely. I found a way to visually confirm that 1 micron affects the progression into the gap of the gauge block. A microcutter is installed on top of the straight edge. The division on the scale is 0.2 micron. A load of 2 kilograms bends the straight edge by 1 micron. The gap has become smaller by 1 micron. I pushed through the gauge blocks, and both rest against the gap. Both springs are bent. I am picking up the load. The microcutter shows that the gap has increased by 1 micron, and the first block passes into the gap. I apply hot water to the top of a straight edge. Near hot water, the steel expands. The straight edge bends and the gap increases by another micron. The second gauge block also passes. The experiment was filmed simultaneously with 3 cameras. Thank you for your attention and support. Bye.